keeping the rich functions, exporting the human life and the model. Let us follow up on our mission, Father. Today was the day when we were kept as a parish community to be able to get our community to celebrate the Eucharist.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Ezekiel. The angel brought me back to the door of the temple, and behold, water was issuing from below the threshold of the temple toward the east, and the water was flowing down from below the south end of the threshold of the temple, south of the altar. Then he brought me out by way of the north gate and led me round on the side to the outer gate that faces towards the east, and the water was coming out on the south side. Going on eastward with a line in his hand, the man measured 1,000 cubits and then led me through the water, and it was ankle deep. Again he measured 1,000 and led me through the water, and it was knee deep. Again he measured 1,000 and led me through the water, and it was up to the loins. Again he measured 1,000 and it was a river that I could not pass through, for the water had risen. It was deep enough to swim in, a river that could not be passed through. And he said to me, "Son of man, have you seen this?" Then he led me back along the bank of the river. As I went back, I saw upon the bank of the river very many trees on the one side and on the other. And he said to me, "This water flows towards the eastern region and goes down into the Araba, and when it enters the stagnant waters of the sea, the water will become fresh. And wherever the river goes, every living creature which swarms will live, and there will be very many fish. For this water goes there, that the waters of the sea may become fresh. So everything will live where the river goes, and on the banks, on both sides of the river, there will grow all kinds of trees of fruit. Their leaves will not wither, nor their fruit fail, but they will bear fresh fruit every month, because the water of them flows from the sanctuary. Their fruit will be for food, and their leaves for healing." The word of the Lord. Your response: the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. God is for us a refuge and strength, a helper close at hand in time of distress. So we shall not fear, though the earth should rock, though the mountains fall into the depths of the sea. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. The waters of a river give joy to God's city, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within it, cannot be shaken. God will help it at the dawning of the day. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come, consider the works of the Lord, the redoubtable deeds he has done on the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Gospel acclamation. Seek God and not evil, that you may live, and soul to the Lord will be with you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. There was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. And now there is in Jerusalem by the sheep gate a pool, in Hebrew called Bethesda, which has five porticos. In these lay a multitude of invalids, blind, lame, paralyzed. One man was there who had been ill for 38 years. When Jesus saw him and knew that he had been lying there so long, he said to him, "Do you want to be healed?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is troubled. And while I am going, another steps down before me." Jesus said to him, "Rise, take up your pallet and walk." And at once the man was healed. He took up his pallet and walked. Now that day was the Sabbath. So the Jews said to the man who was cured, "It is the Sabbath. It is not lawful for you to carry the pallet." But he answered them, "The man who healed me said to me, 'Take up your pallet and walk.'" They asked him, "Who is the man who said to you, 'Take up your pallet and walk'?" Now the man who had been healed did not know who it was, for Jesus had withdrawn as there was a crowd in the place. Afterward, Jesus found him in the temple and said to him, "See, you are well. Sin no more, that nothing worse may befall you." The man went away and told the Jews that it was Jesus who had healed him. And this was why the Jews persecuted Jesus, because he did this on the Sabbath. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we just listened to two beautiful readings. The first reading from the prophet Ezekiel, speaking so beautifully and powerfully on the water, which symbolizes the Holy Spirit, the ankle level, the knee level, the waist level, and then we are taken over by the Spirit of God to such a way that it is He who will carry us. No more we making an effort. But in the initial stages of our journey in the Holy Spirit, when we begin this Christian journey, faith journey, our experience of the Spirit was there right from the beginnings of our life, but our steps, we had to make that journey. We had to make that effort to grow in the Spirit. The Spirit kept on flowing. And in the Gospel, we listened to about the healing. After so many years of his remaining there, finally he goes through the experience of healing, and he did not know who it was. Today we are at a juncture of time, at a time when we are not even aware what's the reason. Many think that it may be a wrath of God. Upon humanity because of its turning away from the ways of God, from God's word, into wickedness. Something very beautiful which the letter of, second letter of St. Paul to Corinthians, chapter 1 verse 9, it says, want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, of afflictions we experienced in Asia, for we were so utterly, unbearably crushed that we despaired of life itself. And verse 9 says, indeed, we felt that we had received the sentence of death, so that we could rely not on ourselves, but on God who raises the dead. Man has reached a stage when self-reliance becomes a hallmark of his life. But today we are called to bow before a simple, small, little virus. Where has the self-reliance of man gone? Today we are called to depend on the Lord, on Jesus. And verse 10 says, he who rescued us from so deadly a peril will continue to rescue us. A promise which is given to us, he will continue to rescue us. It is God's mercy that we are going to experience. But the call is to come back to him, to depend on him. Look at the life of Saint John Bosco, how he depended when situations arose in such a way, not even the government was ready to face this challenge of cholera that was spread in Turin in 1854. Most challenging moment. He with his young boys moves out into the streets to bury the dead, to care for the sick. His dependence was on the divine through Mary, help of Christians. Depended on Jesus. Because he fully believed in this verse that we just listened to, verse 10. He who rescued us from so deadly a peril will continue to rescue us. God's salvation that is already meted out to us, he will continue to rescue us. He will not allow us to be destroyed. In the letter of St. Paul to Romans, chapter 8, verse 18, this brings a lot of consolation to us today as we face this challenge of coronavirus. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. So beautifully presented by Saint Paul. The sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. We are called to experience God's glory. That's our call. The final destiny is God's glory that we will enjoy. And so we are called to go through this time of challenge, of difficulties, of trials. We cannot compare it with God's glory. And that is why Don Bosco never was worried when situations went, according to human terms, when it was out of hand. It was said of him, when he was in great difficulty, he was found smiling all the more. That was his trust in the Blessed Virgin. In Romans 8:28, we know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. And so at this juncture, we are called not for any other purpose but to love. We are in a way compelled to love. The whole world has turned out to be as one simple, one single nation. Everyone is focusing on how to save people. All the nations. The love for one another, love for humanity that we are called for. Letter to Hebrews, chapter 5, verse 8 and 9. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. The victory that is won for us is through the obedience of God. Jesus himself had to go through this experience of struggle of humanity in order to save us. And verse 9, and having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation. In order to be made perfect, we have to go through this peril, go through this struggle that we are called for. Again, Hebrews 12, verse 6. For the Lord, verse 5 says, and you have forgotten the exhortation that addressed you as children. My child, do not regard lightly the discipline of the Lord, or lose heart when you are punished by him. For the Lord disciplines those he loves. It's a part of our disciplining. Disciplining of our world that has gone to a wrong direction. Like a child that is disciplined and chastises every child whom he accepts. My dear friends, today when we reflect on this situation that the whole world considers as a dangerous situation, the consolation which the Lord is giving us is that there is the after effect of this, which has been already won for us by Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 5 and 6, as we conclude this short reflection. Chapter 1, verse 5 says, for just as the sufferings of Christ are abundant for us, so also our consolation is abundant through Christ. So beautifully Saint Paul presents to us, just as the sufferings of Christ are abundant for us, so also our consolation is abundant through Christ. And verse 6, if we are being afflicted by coronavirus, if we are being afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation. He does not want us to be perished, does not want us to be destroyed. If we are being consoled, it is for your consolation, which you experience when you patiently endure the same sufferings that we are also suffering. The same suffering which Jesus had to go through. Today, let us consider this as a moment of suffering which this entire world has to go through in order to experience this victory over this suffering by Jesus Christ. As we pray for the whole world, as we pray for all those who are suffering today, let us focus our attention and bring all those who are caring for the sick, all those who are assisting the government, the authorities, let us bring to the altar of the Lord. And in a very special way, all those within this territory of our parish, everyone at the altar of the Lord, that we may truly experience this motherly intercession of our Blessed Virgin Mary and of Saint John Bosco in helping us to experience this freedom which the Lord has won for us.
Blessed are you, Lord, the Lord of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth, work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord, the Lord of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become for us the spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord Jesus, we offer you the sacrifice with the humble and contrite heart. Receive them in our mercy. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
With motherly concern.
Sultan, she helps and assists her children in their struggles and dangers as they make their way to the heavenly Jerusalem. For this gift of your goodness, heaven and earth unite in exaltation to sing a new song as we exalt.
Of the resurrection and all the kind of mercy Spiritual dominion is the Lord of all things.
Increase the ability that we can come and be your crown and beautiful paradise. Amen. Blessing of many heavens. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We fly to your patronage, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our teachings and our necessities, but deliver us from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Mary, Mother of Christians, Lord, hear my prayer. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who by the operation of the Holy Spirit did prepare the body and soul of the glorious Virgin Mother Mary to become a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant that as we rejoice in her commemoration, we may by her loving intercession be delivered from present evil and from everlasting death. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We ask we have a priest with me, O God of AUXILIUM, bless me for us. The Lord be with you. And may from the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend on you and remain with you always.